Well, here at the back of the house, and one of our next challenges is kind of this area over here. Well, not really our next challenge, but one of our many challenges. So this is the kind of side deck thing. That's the garage over there, and our little streets over there. So this might be a nice place to sit because it looks like it gets some sun even in the late afternoon. But as you can see, they've put the stones in. They've stepped them down, which is super safety issue. We've only tripped a half a dozen times. And as you can see in the background, all the retaining wall. All the retaining wall up there is has fallen down. So I mean, we'll be working with the neighbors on that. But you can see here that, you know, we got to do something with this deck. And then used to be some kind of gardens. I think we got a lot of whatever we got a lot of them. Looks like some kind of lily type thing. We've got some hostas over there, which is all good and dandy. A lot of rock. Even in the gardens here, it seems to be about 6 inches of dirt or sand or whatever. Well, some okay dirt, and then it's rocks after that. So this whole upper part here seems to be all, you know, rock based. And there's Donna way back there, raking our leaves up once again. This is a couple years worth of leaves. I don't think they did last year, and I'm not sure they really did the year before. This is all really wet land down here on the bottom, really soaking wet. So I think we're looking at putting a fence in here, maybe a good 10, 12, maybe 15 feet from that fence. It's all our property up to that fence. But by having a, we're going to have a chain link fence here, then we'll use the other side of that, and we'll try and get some kind of foliage that's going to fill that in so that we have a nice greenery kind of natural feel about it at the back of the yard without going all crazy, but that really likes to soak up that water, because that's, we want to get that water, you know, generally soaked up pretty good. And then we'll have the fence come along here, and then just on the other side of the three trees up to kind of where the retaining wall is there now. And then a piece over there between his fence and the house. And then that's our backyard, and it'll all be fenced in, and we don't have to worry so much about Zoe. Well, except for the odd hawk or a coyote or something, but other than that, she should be fairly safe.